Hi, St. Clair's. It is the first Sunday of Advent. Instead of getting together and having an Advent workshop this year, your teachers have put together Advent packets with lots of wonderful activities for you to do at home. And we'll drop those off at your home before the first Sunday of Advent. My boys have put together an Advent song. And we'll light a candle and share that with you first. And then Miss Suzanne will share a gospel story called Jesus is Coming. We hope you're staying safe, that you had a good and happy Thanksgiving, and you have a great start to your Advent season.
Advent, Advent, a candle burns. Advent, Advent, a candle burns. First one, then two, then three, then four. Then stands the Christ child at the door.
Hi, boys and girls. Today's reading is from the Gospel of Mark. Because it's the first Sunday of Advent, we change the Gospel writers. So there's Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, and we rotate those. Every year we use a different Gospel writer. So last year was Matthew, and this year starts Mark. And we'll use Mark until Advent of 2021. Just a little information for you. So Knut has asked me to give him like a little phrase to use every week that will tell what the story is about. And I would say the phrase for this week is Jesus is coming, and you'll see why. So the Gospel of Mark chapter 13 verses 24 through 37 goes like this. Jesus said, in those days after that suffering, the sun will be darkened and the moon will not give its light. And the stars will be falling from heaven, and the powers in the heavens will be shaken. Then they will see the Son of Man coming on clouds with great power and glory. Then he will send the angels and gather his elect from the four winds, from the ends of the earth to the ends of heaven. From the fig tree, learn its lesson. As soon as its branches becomes tender and puts forth its leaves, you know that summer is near. So also, when you see these things taking place, you know that he is near at the very gates. Truly, I tell you, this generation will not pass away until all those things have taken place. Heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will not pass away. But about that day or hour, no one knows, neither the angels in heaven, nor the Son, but only the Father. Beware, keep alert, for you do not know when the time will come. It is like a man going on a journey when he leaves home and puts his slaves in charge, each with his work, and commands the doorkeeper to be on the watch. Therefore, keep awake, for you do not know when the master of the house will come, in the evening or at midnight, or at cockcrow or at dawn, or else he may find you asleep when he comes suddenly. And what I say to you, I say to all, keep awake. That's the gospel reading. So we've had some changes in 2020. We all know that. And when you're older, you'll probably look back on this year and think, how did we do this? We've also had plans that got changed or completely arranged. And this is my calendar that I use. I don't put things in my phone. Well, sometimes, but I put things in my calendar and I plan everything. I like to have a calendar like this every year. Well, January and February, I didn't have a lot going on because the end of January, I had surgery on my knee. And then February, I had to recoup. And when I went to the doctor in mid-March, he said, you have recovered well enough to go back to your office at church. And so I called Mary Jane and I said, I'm ready to go back to work. And it was the day that I was allowed to go back to work, according to the letter from the doctor, was St. Patrick's Day. March 17th. And Mary Jane said, we're closing the offices. The bishop says we need to close because of COVID. So imagine my surprise when March rolled around and I'd been sitting in the house for a couple months trying to figure out how to recover from knee surgery. And then all of a sudden my plans changed. Well, everyone's changed. So the office was closed and one event after another was canceled or closed or postponed, like you know. And we had to figure out how to be a church without being in a church. It seemed like we had to be ready for rules and schedules to switch in 1 second. It's pretty hard to plan when things are so topsy-turvy and everything's unexpected. And I'm kind of a planner. So we missed out on a lot of things we'd been planning to do at church and at school and maybe with your sports life or your scouts life or whatever it is that you do. We've missed out on a lot of things. And then just when things started to look like they're going to get better, we were told they weren't getting better. We have all sorts of holiday things planned on the calendar, and then more rules came out, and now we don't know what's coming or how to prepare for all of it or what to do. It's frustrating. I know it's disappointing. It's hard for adults to understand, so I'm sure it's hard for you all to understand. I can hardly keep up with the fighting on when I watch TV on the news. There's fighting about people are arguing. There's natural disasters like hurricanes and sad news. Have you ever noticed any of that? Maybe some of you watch TV sometimes. It's tough. This year has been a tough year for everybody. Well, this year has kind of sounds like what our gospel reading was today. Jesus was talking about the end of things and he spoke of some rather frightening signs and warnings, like the sun and the moon and stars falling and times of trouble. But in the midst of the doom and gloom, there's a beautiful and hopeful promise. For one thing, Jesus promised that he would return. And when that happens, he'll take us all to heaven. That's a joyful thought. He also said that if heaven and earth pass away, his words never will. All things can pass away, but the word of God will last forever. And that's comforting. We can count on that. And we can rejoice in the hope that God's word endures and that he keeps his promises. I know I do. And we can rejoice and eagerly await the return of Jesus. When will that happen? We don't know when that will happen. No one knows. But because of that, we need to be ready at all times. We've had a lot of rapid adjustments to make this year. And there will be more, I think, before COVID is under control and everyone is vaccinated and the scientists and the doctors know how to help us all. But we've got to be ready for anything. And that's how it is with the return of Jesus. The gospel says to stay awake. Last week, I sang a little song that came from the gospel reading, and it goes, stay awake, be ready. You do not know the hour of the time. And I forgot the rest of the words, but I remember the tune and I remember the first part of the words. So being ready means that we keep loving and serving God. In this season of change and confusion, we can cling to the hope and to the knowledge that God is always going to be God. And we are always going to be able to listen to and trust in his word, and that our lives will be better if we love God and we serve God and others. So this week, like I said before, begins the week of Advent. And do you know what Advent means? The word Advent means coming. And we remember happily how Jesus came as a baby and what he did for us. But we also, like I said earlier, we look forward to his return, to his eventual second coming. So no matter what happens, even at school, if you're in school or you're out of school, or if you're back and forth, or if you're hybrid, if stores close or if they open, if movie theaters are open or if they're closed, all our plans have to be altered, and we need to expect the unexpected, which is kind of the way we've rolled this year in 2020. We can put our hope in expecting Jesus now and in the future. So I hope you have a good Advent and be prepared and know he's coming. We celebrate the coming of his birth as a baby, and we celebrate the coming when he'll come back one day. So Advent has two meanings. It's very interesting. So this is the prayer I'd like to close with. Dear God, thank you for the hope of Christ's return. Thank you that your word will never pass away. Help us to trust in you even when things are hard and times are uncertain. Thank you for your love. In Jesus' name, amen. By the time you probably see this, Thanksgiving will be over, so I hope you enjoyed some kind of festivities with your family. And I'll look forward to talking to you next week. Take care. Bye-bye.